All right, we're on camera.
Smile, you're on camera.
Actually, you're not.
Okay, today's bat is the lesson. Let's factor that x squared minus 25. Anytime you have two perfect squares, I want you to do what I've been doing since I was in high school. Oh, perfect square, plus, minus. I do that every time. And I always put the minus second, because if that's the one that can be factored again, I don't have to get, they won't be out of order. Anyway, square root of that, x, square root of that, 5. Cancel, cancel. 1 over x plus 5. What do you think?
That's easy.
Did you do that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Did anybody just put x plus 5?
I put 1 over 5.
Somebody in every class.
I was gonna put...
Putting just x plus 5 is like saying 4 eighths is 2. 4 eighths is 1 half.
I knew about it.
You can do it.
Okay, you got to really know your factoring to do this lesson. All we're doing is fractions and canceling out factors. Now, here's one that some people got wrong. What can I do with that?
You can
cancel it.
I can, what? What can I do?
You can cancel the now. You can cancel the x's.
Cancel.
That's it.
Yeah. And then you can...
Then you can't do anything. You're done.
So can't.
I was going to say distribute, but...
No, then you'd have to factor it again.
Yeah.
All right. Here's another one. Confuses people. Can I cancel my X's now?
No.
Why not?
Because it's addition.
Can I cancel my X's now?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Just want to clear up some problems. All right, here's your next one. X squared plus 7X plus 10 all over X squared plus 2X. What do you think? This is gonna be two binomials. By the way, just a reminder, if there's no number here, you start like that every time.
Plus
5 plus 2.
Plus plus. Very good. It's plus plus.
5 and 2.
5 and 2.
5 and 2. Doesn't matter which one you put first. What do we got here?
Plus.
X plus X plus X.
There's no number for
plus.
You can't do two binomials, or you'll end up with a middle term.
2x plus X.
Plus minus is the difference of two squares.
Put 2x plus X to the second. Like you
bring
it down.
X in standard form.
Bring it down.
Can't bring it down. It's factorable.
XX.
Oh.
X.
GCF.
GCF is the first thing you do no matter what. No matter what. GCF is first.
Oh, wait.
X times. Well, look at that.
Hey, I got it.
Final answer. X plus 5 over X. GCF is always first. There isn't any factoring problem where the first thing you shouldn't say is there a GCF. There isn't one. All right. 24A, 16A, plus 4. Can I reduce those?
Mm-hmm.
The answer is no. Why?
Oh, because there's a...
Because it's a sum. All right, but you can factor the denominator. What do you get? GCF.
4A.
A plus 1. A plus 1. 4A
plus
1.
Now what?
24 divided by 4.
24 divided by 4, because this is now a multiplication, is 6. Final answer, 6A, 4A, plus 1. Can I do anything else?
Yes.
What?
No.
We don't know, never mind. It's addition.
Because it's addition, you cannot. You can't. I proved it last period. Kid wouldn't believe me. Can't do it. You know how you can prove it? Let's say you're stuck on a test. You know, can I reduce that to 3 halves? Reduce it. Okay? That would be 3a, 2a plus 1. This is wrong. How do you know it's wrong? Pick any number you want for a. Don't use 0 or 1.
2.
2. All right? Let's put a 2 in. And a 2. And a 2. And a 2. If it's true, you did it right. If it's false, it couldn't have been done. 12 over 9 equals 6 over 5. Nope. You can't do it. That's how you check if you reduced it right. It has to equal.
What's
8? 4 times 2 plus 1. 4 times 2 plus 1. Made me think I did it wrong on camera. All right, we have two trinomials.
X minus.
By the way, number 6 on your homework, the top trinomial can't be factored. There's the GCF, but after you take it out, I made a math error. Sorry.
X.
All right, factors of 24 that give me a positive 2.
+6 - 4.
+6 - 4. Factors of 42 that give me a negative 1.
+6 - -7.
You know, you guys are amazing at factoring. Way better than ever. You really are. All right, what can I do? X minus 4, x minus 7. You need to rewrite it because it won't have parentheses. You don't need to be grouping anything. Can I cancel those out?
No.
Don't you dare cancel them out. You know, in a multiple choice test, we'll cancel them out and have a choice. Don't do it. All right. Here's the one I messed up on your notes, but I'm going to fix it on for you guys so you don't have to worry about it.
Minus seven plus two.
How about here?
Eight. Minus, isn't it?
Seven.
Eight and seven. Final answer. X plus 2, x minus 8. How about I reduce that?
No.
Addition.
You better keep saying no.
Yeah, cool.
Here's one that's a little different.
Can we just move them around?
You should move them around. -2x + 10. I wish you'd pay attention all year. You'd be killing it right now.
What?
All right, what do I do now?
GCF.
GCF.
Oh, no, negative.
No, you're right. GCF is always first.
-2.
Well, we're going to make the GCF negative. That'll get rid of both.
Okay.
The negative. You don't need to get a negative out and then GCF. Just take your GCF and make it negative.
All
right.
Okay.
X minus 5.
Final answer?
-2.
Would be
that means no matter what number you put in here, you can check these on a test. You're going to get -2, no matter what number you put in. You believe me?
Yeah.
It's true. Pick a number.
We're going to argue with where we're going.
That's 7. I just made that.
-14.
No matter what you pick, you're going to get -2. That's how you know you did it right.
If you put the square.
Then you're obviously.
No, use 0. Sometimes 0 works and no other number works. So it's a bad thing to check. We only got 2 left, and the last one is the hardest, and you're going to try it.
X plus 6.
X minus 6.
Done. All right, you try the hardest one. You get the hardest one right, you can't possibly miss one. What's the first thing you always ask yourself?
GCS.
And if you're at home slacking or sick, you should be trying it. Don't be fast forwarding either. So Ryan's in Vegas or no Vegas? Vegas or no Vegas?
Well, when you're in the way, it's just Vegas. Vegas. No.
Yeah, I get that.
No. Take care of it.
You're by myself.
I'm done.
You like salmon?
Yes.
Oh my God, I gotta show you a spice you're gonna put on it.
That's what I eat Friday night when we went out.
I gotta show you. It was so good. The birds had me over for dinner. I took a picture of it. It's at Kroger.
So it's good? What's it called?
There we go.
It's on my phone.
Oh,
I can't.
You can't?
I don't know how to do it, sorry.
The top one or the bottom one?
Well, I think I did. Check the first story. That's what I have.
Okay.
I don't know what to do from there.
The denominator?
I forgot the steps.
The steps? How about G, C, F?
I know.
That's it. How many had it?
Wait, guess.
I was
close.
Close? I forgot to cancel a bit.
All right, that's the lesson. You have 11 of these for homework.
11?
None
11
of them are harder
these,
than that.
What was I going to say?
That was easy.
11's good, no?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I may give this test.